So let's just have a recap, whatever we have read, that there was a giant, right? And he was very selfish. At first, he was very selfish and he didn't allow any child to play in his garden. He actually had reserved the garden for himself only, okay? He put a notice board there that nobody was allowed to enter in this garden. What happened that when the children stopped coming in his garden because of that his refusal only, then what happened? Then later on, the winter means all the weather, all the seasons, they also stopped coming. They also stopped entering in his garden. And as a result, the winter season got a permanent home there and in the garden of the giant, right? And then what happened? Many months passed, but the season that was winter in the giant's garden. Okay. Now what happened? As the children were not allowed, but it is mentioned that how the winter was personified, how there are so many members, including wind, hail, and how they were enjoying in his garden. It was beautifully mentioned in a paragraph, in a single paragraph, and clearly, right? Later on, what happened that one day when actually he was waiting for spring season, okay? But spring season refused to come, and same way the autumn season also refused to come to his garden. Now what happened that one day, he heard some noise, he heard beautiful music. And when he just went out, got up from his bed and he went to his window, he saw a beautiful scene. Beautiful, you can say he witnessed something beautiful. And what was that? That there was spring in his garden. But in addition to that spring season, he also witnessed children playing in his garden. So it means when the children came back to his garden, there was a small hole in the wall. Through that hole, the children came into the garden. So when the children were there in the garden, they were enjoying, and with them, the trees were also enjoying, the birds were singing, they were also very happy. So somehow this transformed the giant's heart, okay? As he was waiting for spring season, he was tired of that sadness, he was tired of that winter season, so he was waiting for happiness. When he saw spring season, when he saw, you can say, happiness, so his heart changed. And then what happened? Then when his heart changed, he went to his garden and then he held a child there, okay? Not only just, it wasn't simply just change of heart. When he actually proved this also, he went to the garden. Little boy was not able to climb the tree. So the giant picked the child up and he then helped him to climb the tree. And as soon as the little boy touched the tree, there was spring season in that corner also. Now the boy was very happy. So to show his love, he hugged the giant and he also kissed him. Okay. Now we are going to read from page number 22. Okay, Jevon, get ready. Second paragraph, all day long. Start.
Yes, ma'am. All day long they played, and in the evening they came to the giant to bid him goodbye. But where is your little companion? He said, the boy I put into the tree. The giant loved him the best because he had kissed him. We don't know, answered the children. He has gone away. You must tell him to be sure and come tomorrow, said the giant. But the children said that they did not know where he lived. Giant, very good, and had never seen him before. And the giant felt very sad.
Wait.
Every afternoon.
Now what happened that in the evening, the children enjoyed whole day there. They played in the garden, and in the evening they came to say goodbye to the giant. But when they came, the giant asked for the little boy, little companion, their little companion, children, okay? He asked for their little companion and they said that they didn't know him. Actually, they were unaware, you can say unaware of him. They said that they didn't know him, where he lived or what was his name. So the giant was sad because he loved that child so much. In just, you can see, in just one meeting, he started loving that child so much because the child showed him love. Nobody else had ever done this thing, okay, showing love to him. But the child, he showed love. He hugged him, he kissed him. So the giant was somehow connected. He got connected to the boy. That is why he was asking for that little boy. And he asked other children to tell him to come tomorrow. But they said that they did not know where he lived and they had never seen him before. So this was the first time that they had seen him. Okay, and that they don't know about him. They didn't know about his whereabouts. Okay, so the giant was very sad after hearing this. Now Anmol, you start reading. Yes, Bani, just wait.
Every afternoon when school was over, the children came and played with the giant. But the little boy whom the giant loved was never seen again. The giant was very kind to all the children, yet he longed for his little friend and often spoke of him. "How I would like to see him," he used to say. Years went by and the giant grew very old and feeble. He could not play about anymore, so he sat in a huge armchair and watched the children at their games and admired his garden. "I have many beautiful flowers," he said, "but the children are the most beautiful flowers of all."
Just wait, and hold wait. Now what happened? That every afternoon, means now this was the routine. The children, they daily came there. They started coming daily, okay? And they enjoyed in the garden. And in addition to that, the giant also started playing with them, okay? So the children, they came, they played with the giant, they enjoyed every afternoon after their school. But the little boy whom the giant loved was never seen again. The little boy whom the giant picked and helped to climb the tree, he was never seen again. Means he was not able to meet him again. It was only that day when the little boy came. But still the giant was very kind to all the children. And he enjoyed with them. He never stopped them from doing anything. Yet he wished for his little friend. Okay, yet he wanted to meet his that little friend, little boy. And then he used to talk to him. Wo usi se apne aap hi baat karta tha. Sometimes he start talking to us. Matlab apne aap se baat kar rahe hote hai na, keeping in mind someone else. So he used to talk to him that how I would like to see him. Means he was desperate to meet him. He desperately wanted to see him. Okay. So years went by. It was not about months or days, but salo beat gaye, right? Years went by and the giant now was very old and weak. So now after so many years, the giant became old. He was old now and he was weak. So he could not play anymore. This was the reason that he stopped playing with the children. But still he didn't restrict them from coming and enjoying his garden. What he used to do, he used to sit in a chair, huge armchair, and he used to watch them. He see the comparison he has done. He said that there are many beautiful flowers in his garden, but he said the children are the most beautiful flowers of all. He has compared the children to the flowers. Okay, the way the flowers spread fragrance all around, happiness all around, they are colorful, right? They bring joy, pleasure. Same way the children, they also, they spread happiness, they spread joy. Okay, they bring, you can say, he was quite active then. It wasn't dull. Something was, his garden was not dull now. It was beautiful. It was, you can say, blooming. So he has compared the children to him, to the flowers. Yes, Punya, now your turn. Unmute.
Yes, ma'am. One winter morning, he looked out of his window as he was dressing. He did not hate the winter now, for he knew that it was merely the spring asleep and that the flowers were resting. Suddenly, he rubbed his eyes in wonder and looked. It certainly was a marvelous sight. In the farthest corner of the garden was a tree quite covered with lovely with blossoms. Its branches were golden and silver fruit hung down from them, and underneath it stood the little boy he had loved. Downstairs ran the giant in grief.
Now what happened? That one means now the year passed, the seasons changed. So one winter morning, again in that garden, in that house, you can say there was winter. But this time, it wasn't that sad winter. Okay, because, and right now, he didn't hate that winter because he knew that it was just for some time. With the passage of time, this winter would also leave his garden. Okay, and just see how beautifully they have depicted this, the writer. He did not hate the winter now, for he knew that it was merely the spring asleep. Jo spring hai, wo sirf so rahi hai. This is the beautiful depiction by the writer. And that the flowers were resting. Means now he started looking for positivity in the winter season also. What he said, that the spring is asleep and the flowers, they are just resting. They are on rest. So after some time, they'll be active again and they will again add beauty to his garden. Now what happened, that suddenly he was dressing up, okay, he was maybe changing his clothes and all. So suddenly he started rubbing his eyes in wonder. And why so? Because it was a marvelous sight. Marvelous, very, you can say, he was amazed to see that. He was very happy to see that. What was that? In the farthest corner of the garden was a tree, quite covered with lovely white blossoms. Its branches were golden. Means everywhere there was winter. But still in one corner of his garden, the tree was covered with white blossoms, right? And then the branches were golden, silver fruit. Means still in that part of the garden, there was spring. And what was the reason? The reason was that underneath it stood, that under that tree stood the little boy he had loved. So means after so many years, after waiting for so many years, he finally got the chance to meet the little boy he loved so much. Okay, so now what happened, that in that corner still there was spring, and the reason was the boy, little boy whom he loved. Yes, Bani, your turn.
Downstairs ran the giant in great joy, and out into the garden. He hastened across the grass and come near to the child. And when he come quite closer, his face grew red with anger, and he said, "Who had dared to wound thee? For on the palms of the child's hand were prints of two nails, and the print of two nails were on the little feet. Who had dared to wound the?" cried the giant. "Tell me that I may take my big sword and slay him."
Wait, now what happened? Now when he saw the boy, he was very happy. Okay, he was very, very happy that he just ran downstairs and then he directly ran into the garden. He hastened, means he hurried across the grass. He was just running to meet that boy, okay? And when he came near to that child, his face grew red in anger. मतलब जैसे ही उसके पास, अदरवाइज ही वॉज वेरी हैप्पी, बट एज सून एज ही रीच्ड टू दैट चाइल्ड, नियर दैट चाइल्ड, व्हाट हैपेंड, ही वॉज एंग्री नाउ, हिज फेस ग्रू रेड विद एंगर. And what was the reason? The reason you will come to know here, that on the palms of the child's hands, okay, haathon pe yahan pe were the prints of two nails, heel, nails, heel, heel hoti hai na, okay? So print of two nails were there, and the prints of two nails were on the little feet, not only on the hands but on the feet also, pairon pe bhi and hands pe bhi. नेल्स के निशान थे कीलों के. ठीक है, नाउ ही आस्क्ड हु हैथ डेयर्ड टू वूंड दी. हैथ मींस हैव, एच ए वी ई हैव, ओल्ड, दिस इज द ओल्ड स्टाइल ऑफ राइटिंग, एंड दी मींस यू. सो ही वाज सो एंग्री, ही जस्ट आस्क्ड दैट हु, एक्चुअली इट शुड बी हैज, राइट? सो बट इन दैट दैट टाइम old English they used to use have for this also singular. So who have dared to wound you? He asked ki tumhe chot kisne pahunchayi hai. Again, who had dared to wound you? Cried the giant. Tell me. He was so angry that he said that just tell me, I'll take my big sword and I'll kill that person who did this to you. So now, can you tell this part? For on the palms of the child's hand were the prints of two nails. Prints of two nails were on little feet. Can you connect it to something, someone, something? Have you ever heard about such kind of thing ever? Yes, bache. Have you ever heard about such kind of thing ever in your life? Nobody? Okay. Giant has, okay, no, not this. Yes, Anvi, correct. This is correct. Jesus Christ, I hope you know about the incident of that pins and nails. Do you know that or not? Sabhi ko bata hota hai ye to. Yes, are you aware of that or not? Yes. So, this, can't you connect it with that? That with for Jesus Christ when there were nails on, prints of nails on his hands also and on his feet also. When he was crucified, right? When he was crucified that time, what उन्हें इसी के through लटकाया गया था, जब लटकाया गया था that cross पे जब लटकाया था. So now let's see what happens. Okay, Prabal, you want to read, so just read. Unmute and read.
Yes, ma'am. Nay, answered the child, but these are the wounds of love. Who are thou? Said the giant. And a strange way fell on him, and he knelt before the little child. And the child smiled on the giant and said to him, you let me play once in your garden. Today you shall come with me to my garden, which is paradise. And when the children ran in that afternoon, they found the giant lying dead under the tree, all covered with white blossoms.
Yes, so this story is written by Oscar Wilde, right? Now what is the ending? The child said, nay, means no need to kill anyone, okay, no need to hurt anyone. He said that these are not the wounds of, you can say these wounds are not hurting me, right? They are the wounds of love. Means people showed their love to me. That is why I got these. These are just those wounds. These wounds don't hurt me. Ye mujhe chot nahi pahuncha rahe hain. Then the giant was surprised. So he asked, who are you? Said the giant, and a strange awe fell on him, and he knelt before the little child. And he was amazed, in wonder, he just sat there. Wo wahi pe baith gaya before the little child. Uske aage chup gaya us little child ke aage. Why so? Maybe he realized that child was not just a simple little boy, normal little boy. That child represented God. Okay, the child was, you can say, the messenger of God or the God himself, because of, you can say, the prince. You can say this also. And the child smiled on the giant and said to him, you let me play once in your garden. So the child said that you allowed me to play once in your garden, and you, today you shall come with me to my garden, which is paradise. Okay, heaven. So the child said that you allowed me to play once in your garden. Now it is my turn. So I'm going to take you to my garden, that is paradise. Okay, so this indicates that the God came in his garden to take the giant with him. Okay. And when the children ran in that afternoon, other children, those who used to come and play, when the children ran in that afternoon, they found the giant lying dead under the tree, all covered with white blossoms. Okay. Otherwise, just see, pure jo unka garden tha, there was winter. But where the boy was standing, there was spring. Right, still, there was spring. And then this last part, giant lying dead under the tree, all covered with white blossoms. This shows that how his heart was changed. And this heart, the change of that heart was not temporary. It was permanent. And because of that, he got reward also. Okay, he got reward. The spring for the season, for he waited so long. The season for which he waited so long. While he died, right, jabu ki death hui, that time, that where he was lying under that tree, that time, that area, in that area, particular area, there was still spring. Means he got everything that he ever wanted. Okay, so let's start the question answers. Be ready to answer the questions. So, the giant saw a most wonderful sight. What did he see? First, in the beginning, what did he see? Yes, Avni. Yes, indeed, it is a beautiful ending. Beautiful ending. See, how if we just behave, you can say, in a proper way, or we are, you can say, selfless, then God also, they come us, God come us, come to us, and they are really happy. They shower their blessings over us also. So if you are selfless, then only, not selfish. Okay, so he saw that the winter was over. The trees covered themselves with birds. Winter was over and trees covered themselves with birds and blossoms, and children were playing and were very happy. Correct, Angel? Correct. The giant saw that the children had crept into his garden through a little hole in the wall and sat on the branches of the trees. As the children filled the garden, the trees, yes, the answer is simple. The trees, not only, the children were there in the garden, okay? And with the entrance of that, those children came the spring also. The season was changed. Now winter was not there, it was spring season. Flowers were blooming, birds were very happy, they were singing and they were flying here and there. So the sight was very pleasant, okay, as he was waiting for this sight. What did he realize on seeing it? Yes, what did he realize? Yes, Avni, correct. That is correct. Now the second part, what did he realize on seeing it? Did he realize his mistake or not? What did he realize? Quick, bache, we have to finish it. What did he realize on seeing it, on seeing the sight, that sight of beautiful garden where children were playing, birds were enjoying? He realized that he himself was to be blamed, right? Yes, he realized that only he was to be blamed for that he built the wall around the garden and stopped the children from entering, and the winter was there and the spring was not able to come. Yes, he realized that he was selfish, okay? He realized that he was selfish. He didn't allow the children to come and enjoy in his garden, and because of him only, there was winter. Okay. Yes. Yes. Correct, Angel. He was sorry for whatever he had done. Yes, Avni. He realized that he had made a big mistake by not allowing the children to play as the nature liked playing with children. Correct. Like children playing. Okay. That is correct. Why was it still winter in one corner of the garden? The answer is very simple. Why was it still winter in one corner of the garden? Yes, bachche. What was the reason? Reason of winter in the garden. Yes, because still winter in the garden because it was a little boy standing there. He was so small that he was not able to reach the branch of tree. Right, and trying the tree bent his branches down as low as possible so that the boy could climb, but he was too small, right? Because the little child was not able to climb the tree, even the tree was trying, the tree bent his branches so that the child can touch it, but everything was in vain. So still in that corner there was winter, as the child was not able to touch the tree. Okay. All the trees have at least one child. So those trees were broke into thousands, but only one tree was left where one child couldn't climb. So that's why, yes, correct, Bhavika. Correct. Paramjit, correct answer. This is correct. But don't start your answer with because, okay? Describe the first meeting of the little boy and the giant. First meeting of the little boy and the giant. It was, I think, very beautiful meeting. It was the first time that the giant experienced love. The giant felt love. Okay, he felt that he was loved. Okay, so there in the first meeting of the little boy and the giant, it was heart-touching. He was very happy. A beautiful meeting. And the giant lifted that boy. He helped the boy to climb the tree. And in return, the child hugged the giant and also kissed him. So he showed his love towards the giant. And this was the first time that the giant ever felt being loved, or he was showered with love. Okay. Prabal is saying in the first meeting of the boy and the giant lifted him gently and put him in the branch of that tree. The tree suddenly broke into flowers. Yes, I skipped this, that the tree suddenly broke into flowers and the birds began to sing in that corner also. The child kissed the giant. Okay. Okay, when the giant saw a little child crying near a tree, he bent near the child, picked him up and made him sit on the tree. The child became very happy and the child hugged him, gave him a kiss. The tree was also covered with green leaves. Correct, Avni, correct. Okay, able to climb, the giant's heart melted and helped him to reach tree. Yes, Anmol, correct. Correct answer. Just add that this was also the first time that the giant was showered with love. The giant felt the love. Describe their second meeting. After so many years, when the giant was old and weak, they met again. Okay, in the second meeting of child and the giant, the child was actually not the child, but he was God in disguise, okay, who came to take him to his garden, which is heaven, correct. Yes, the giant saw wounds on the child, little boy's palms and feet. He became furious. He wanted to kill the man who had wounded the child, but the boy said that those were wounds of love. This is also correct. You can write in either way, means you can mention that it was God, not the child, and the God came to take him. In the first meeting of the boy and the giant, the second meeting was when giant was so old and feeble, and one day he saw the child and he was so happy. But he was vexed to see wounds, and then he came to know that boy was God. Correct, Angel. Correct answer. Last, the giant lay dead, all covered with white blossoms. What does this sentence indicate about the one selfish giant? Was he selfish now also when he died? OK, that this indicates that the giant had been blessed by Lord Christ himself. Correct, Raghav? He was neither cruel nor selfish. So Christ forgave him and took him to paradise. Correct, Ram? He was granted the forgiveness from the God. Giant was blessed to live in paradise. Yes, he was blessed to live in paradise after his death. He was no longer selfish. He wasn't cruel anymore. And he was covered with white blossoms in his garden. The white blossoms indicate that the giant had a peaceful death. Correct. He was blessed by Jesus and he was very happy. And then God invited him to his paradise. Correct. God himself came to take him. You have to do these questions and first comprehension check in your notebook. Now just see, discuss the following topics in group. The little child's hands and feet had marks of nails. Who do the child remind you of? I think you already know. We have discussed this. And you can write this as a diary entry. Is there something like this garden near where you live? Kahi hai sa kuch garden? Would you like one without the giant perhaps? And why? Would you like if there is no garden? Would you like to have that garden? And if yes, then why? What would you do to keep it in good shape? Paramjit has given the last answer that this indicates that he had changed his behavior permanently. He was not selfish at all. That Lord Jesus himself came to take him, which means he was purely changed. Correct, Paramjit? The giant was earlier very selfish, but God when gave him chance to change himself, he changed himself. Yes, into a selfless person. Yes, God gave him chance. This is correct. The God was pleased with him and took him with himself to the paradise. Correct. Correct answer. So we have finished this chapter. Let's see, tomorrow we'll start with other book or grammar topic.